I've been through this so many times, trying to get rid of stuff. Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. I'm here in my entryway to show you my living room. I've made some changes, mostly to the color palette. I wanted to show it to you before I make more changes. So I had a West Elm designer come in and give her ideas. So I'm just saving up money now in order to put those ideas into fruition. From our entryway, there are two steps here that goes into our living room. And so several years ago, we actually had a flood in our house. And so the insurance paid for this new tile. So I just haven't been able to do the rest of the tile because it is pretty expensive. And the main thing I've done here is that I've taken off the stuff that was on the wall. And I'm waiting to find a piece that I really like that's gonna be the whole size of it. And I've actually even just left the holes in there, I just haven't had time. And the other thing that the designer suggested was, because I really want this couch, which is a sofa bed from West Elm. And so this is still a sofa bed. It's so old, there's actually a hole over here that my dog had chewed up way, way back. And so I just have a cover and I changed the pillows in the back. And so I just have these pillows and most, I think a couple of these from TJ Maxx, and then the inserts and the covers I just got from Amazon. And of course, like everything, I'll link everything below or put it in my store. This is from Target and I did change out the pots for my plants. This plant was doing really, really well. And then once I transferred it, it just hasn't been exactly the same. You could see it dying here. If you know what to do with that, please let me know. And then let me just show you the other plant here. I do plan to change the planter there and have the same one. This is the money tree. I love it. It's growing so well. It was in two different spots, one in my dining room, one in my living room. When I finally put it here, it started really growing. And once a month, sometimes a few times a month, I will put water in there for the humidifier because it does really well with humidity. All right, the other thing is that I will be changing out these two chairs. I bought them on Amazon. I really don't like them. They're not the most comfortable, but I definitely didn't want the ones that were here before. We've had that for years. And oh, by the way, I've had my couch for like 20 years. And then I just went ahead and put these velvet pillow covers and have that because it kind of matches the chairs in my dining room. I've had this forever. I think that's from Ross. And I do plan to get a drink table from West Elm. This table I got from Facebook Marketplace. It was like $40. I absolutely love it, but I am gonna get a new one. She explained to me that because of the space, it would do really well with a circular table. And I love the one she showed me. It has, it's like a drum and there's storage inside. So I like that to put blankets or whatever. And especially in your house when, if you're like me, because I am a prepper, I do need storage in different spots. And so let's see, the other thing I've done is that I've changed out the rug. So that was the first thing I did, was I changed out the rug. It was a pink, beautiful boho rug. There were stains from it, from my sweet Molly, and I could never get it out no matter what I tried to do. I even had it professionally clean. And anyway, so I said, you know, it's time to change the rug. So that was a little bit sentimental, even though I couldn't get those, or even kind of the smell out of it, I think. I was still sentimental. Isn't it crazy how you get sentimental over things? Okay, let's see what else here. I do like to put a tray, and I usually have a candle and coasters. Just make sure people use coasters on the tables. And this was a recent purchase I got from Amazon. I absolutely love it. It's by that Christopher Knight, yes. Because I got two tables and I love that, but I moved it to my family room, so I had to get replacements here. I think that's, I don't wanna, you know what, I'm not sure. Anyway, I checked on Amazon, then I checked on Walmart. It was $30 cheaper each on Walmart. So I ordered from Walmart, got it in 2 days. So that's something to think about when you're getting anything, is just to kind of price compare. And then over here, you could see another plant. This plant has done okay. It was really thriving. And then when I replanted it, it's been fine. You know, it hasn't like grown as much as it did before, but it's still doing well. And this is a new purchase, this little storage ottoman, and I wanted to get that, you know, like I said, if I need to store canned goods in there, I can do that. Dehydrated food, you know, no one will know. Oh, by the way, if ever I have the chance, I did look this up one time, behind my piano, there's this, you know, there's a, because you see my stairs, there's a landing. There's a whole space in there that I can use for prepping. But anyway, that's another video. So anyway, I got this and I just put a pillow there. It's not the most comfortable place, but is a spot to just sit for a little while. I love this little lamp that I got from Amazon, okay? And then this piano is 45 years old. I had it when I was a kid. My parents had it for several years. They gave it to us when my son started playing piano, but he's not, he's on the East Coast now. And he said I could sell this or give it away or whatever. So I looked online and we found my husband has a piano teacher for a client, and there was someone who came to look at it and they're like, no, it's too big. We have an apartment. And I'm thinking, well, the only other smaller thing you can get is a keyboard. So anyway, once the West Elm designer suggested that we put a bench here because we do use this spot for, you know, small parties and gatherings, and just wanted more seating. I mean, it's great to have the piano. It's very sentimental. Trust me, it takes a lot out of me to even say it's okay to donate the piano when it's time, okay? And then when that person didn't want it anymore, it was like right away, I like, oh, I'm not letting go of the piano anymore. But now I'm just like, you know what? The time will come where we will let this go. But the time is not now. So let's look at this bench. Okay, so I know in this bench, there are things here that I should probably let go of, but I think I'm not going to until the piano is gone. And I might just keep some of it and put it in my kids' keepsake bin. If it doesn't fit there, I have to let it go. Okay, so I've been through this so many times trying to get rid of stuff, and I just know that I'm not gonna get rid of any more. Look at this. That's like stuff when I was playing piano as a kid. Oh, what is this? Oh my gosh, this is crazy. See how crazy I am? This is my son's diploma that I need to get framed. I literally thought it was in my... Oh, this, it does not go here. Oh, I wonder why it's all here. Okay, and his piano teacher had given him this, so we're gonna keep that. Like, I mean, I don't even have the machine, but I'm gonna keep it because I'm sure it has my son playing on there. And look at this, this is like from forever ago. So I'm gonna take these and put them, oh, not this one, put them in a safer spot, okay? All right, so I'm not letting go of anything for now. And by the way, these are the two piano bags that my kids had, look at that, 2008, with their music in it. And I keep it there, I'm very sentimental. This is one of the sentimental things that I have. And so, you know, my best suggestion for sentimental things and making decisions about sentimental items, you have to be, don't make the decision until you're ready. But how do you get ready? So for me, I had a designer come in and design, you know, pick furniture for our living room whenever I get the chance to do that, right? And what is the function of the space is we want more seating. So like right now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, if we had a bench, we might have 7, 8. You know, that is better for me than pulling the dining chairs in. Okay, so I'd rather have that above having a piano sitting here, and I barely play, I'm not that good anyway. And if my son had already given me permission that we can let it go, if anything, I can get a keyboard. So preparing yourself for that decision. So I've set it up for, you know, the design, the function I want for the place, my son gave me permission. So until you have those things in place, you know, you don't have to make those sentimental decisions. You don't have to let go of those things that are not necessarily cluttering up your space, right? So if it's like obviously cluttering your space, then you need to start making decisions. But for me, there's a place for it. You know, it takes up a small amount of space. It fits in this storage. So if this was brimming over, then yes, I have to start making decisions. If I had bags going up the wall, then yes, I need to make decisions. All right, but when it comes to that time, you know what? You just make the decision and have no regrets. All right, before we go, I do want to show you this one sentimental item. I had two new friends visit from Kenya. They're part of our church in Kenya, and they came here for a conference. So we housed them and we became friends. It was wonderful. So one of them gave me this. It's a little box, and you know, for the continent of Africa, and they're from Kenya. So this little part that's Kenya, okay, you pull this up and then the box opens. I love it. All right, so that's the overview of where my living room is at. I hope you enjoy this tour and click the next video for more organizing and updates of around my house. Okay, bye.